Hi, so we are part 3 of this beginner Metro bus station creation tutorial. So please subscribe to our channel and also follow me on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook page so that you can keep up when the new parts come up or any other tutorial I do. So originally we were going to be creating the road and the base, but I realized that the road part is actually pretty lengthy. So we're going to be looking at optimizing the the station itself and the base, just this base part. Okay, so again, please subscribe and also follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram account so that you can keep up. So now let's get started. So as you can see that the model is still different parts, like for example I move this part, there's still different material objects. Okay, so we want all of them to be just one big big station. So but before we do that, just hide the wrong one. Click on the station and tab to go to edit mode, A to deselect everything, and use the middle mouse button to move downward, and then click on C to select these bottom faces. And if you have accidentally selected other faces that we don't want, like this over here, you can easily fix them by going to C to side view, C to go to side view, then Z, wireframe, D to box left, and then shift, and then move your mouse to, like over here, to move all of these, and now only the bottom half is selected. Then go back to that solid mode and then click on X and move faces. Like I said, the bottom part is pointless to have. The more edges vertices we have, the more render time it will take. So it wasn't going to be rendered anyway, so it would have been pointless to let it stay there. So now hide the station. A to select everything. Okay, just these parts and the station should be hidden. Okay, now make the station reappear again. And shift and click the station. Now the last thing that we have selected is the station. You can see that the outline of station is light orange and the other are dark orange. And now click on Control J. Okay, so now they're all part of this station. So now if I move this station around, all of them move all together. Okay, and now we don't need this wrong one. So just delete this and move the station a little bit above. We're going to be using it here and there a lot, and you can also see that in the material set the prong material has also been joined with the station as well. So click on Shift A, Mesh, Cube. Now we're going to be making the base, name it base, give it name material, also called base, and give it a lightish gray sort of color. Now click on scale to just move it, make it a little bit bigger, and then G, Z to move it right about over here, and then go into, click on 7 to go into top view, and then S, Shift, Z to make it wider, and make sure that it comes out from the sides from the station. Okay, so now it's wide enough. Now click on S, Y to just scale it on the Y axis. Okay, so in the original I didn't have the station name or anything over here, but we're going to be adding that over here right now. And then wireframe, I think the station could be a little bit of more bigger, so click on the station, tap into edit mode, click to side view, and then that wireframe, deselect everything, go into edge select mode, and then vertex select mode, and then click on B to box set and select the bottom vertices, and then click on G, Z to move them downward. So now that the station is sort of bigger, and then tab out of edit mode, go to side mode, and then G, Z to move them above to here. That right now this looks a lot better now. So now click on the base, tab into edit mode, select this, go into face select mode, select the top face, shift and select the bottom face, shift and select this face, and then shift and select this face, and then right click and click subdivide. So now they're divided. I don't know why. Okay. And now tab come out of edit mode, and now we're going to be giving it a mirror modifier. Click on the mirror modifier, this branch over here, click on this, go into the modifier tab, and then click on mirror modifier. On the bisect tab, click on X, and then on the axis also click on X and remove the X. On the bisect tab, click on Y, and the axis to be also Y, and on the X remove the axis of X. Okay, so now that because this was the positive axis, from what's over here, and then click on the select these vertices and click G, Y to move it, and try to give it this triangular sort of shape. I don't know why it's not working properly. I think it's too pointy. It has some glitches or something. So now we're going to plug it because this is too pointy, and we don't want it to be pointy. We want it to be sort of like smooth out like this. So yeah. So click on Control, then B to bevel it. You see, this is starting to work right now here. And then scroll your mouse wheel to add in a few subdivisions to make it more smoother. Okay, and then click the mouse button to finalize it. So now this has been created. I don't know why it's doing this. It worked pretty fine before, but to point out, you might have some glitches or something. I don't know. So our base has been finalized. So on the next part, we will be creating this road part. I was originally going to make it on this part, but I realized that it was a bit more lengthy. So yeah, we're going to be doing it in a different next part. So please leave a like, subscribe to our channel to stay up to date with the series, and also follow me on social medias. Links are all in the description below. So see you next time. Goodbye.